So, how's our progress
report
looking? Our
large model is shaping up nicely. The agility, the intelligence, it's all looking good. And this human AI co-pilot feature,
we're debuting it on the Xpeng MONA M03 Max.
I'm actually driving it right now. See, it's already in assisted driving
mode. My hands are on the wheel, and if there's a car up ahead, see,
it's waiting. But if I wanna switch up the route, look, it just did it on its own.
Actually, with this version, are we starting to crack residential complexes? 2. We've planted some little Easter eggs. If you guys happen to find that it can suddenly take you home, without any saved routes or to the office, then you should definitely try out this little hidden feature. The assisted driving won't really pay attention to stuff like a manhole cover on the road. But when I'm driving, I totally swerve around a manhole cover. 'Cause it just makes the ride way more comfortable. So in that moment, I can just nudge the wheel, go around the manhole, and it instantly re-engages this during AI co-pilot. I mean, come on, this kind of situation happens all the time. Our goal is to nail this by the end of the year. We're ready to go head-to-head with our friends over in the States. The thing is, with Xpeng's NGP,
a lot of people don't realize how much work we've put in over the last 2 years.
For example, we took a much harder approach, but one with a way higher ceiling. To really perfect this full vision model, we built a foundational world model of the physical world. It's so smart. It chose this lane. It didn't just sit there waiting. Yeah, this lane. 'Cause you might not know, there's a little shortcut here. They actually had me test driving a ton of these backroads today. We're intentionally pushing it on these small roads to show what it can do. Look, just now, there was a guy on a scooter going the wrong way. He was turning from an unmarked road up ahead on the left. The car immediately braked. But it wasn't harsh at all. It was super smooth. That's so important. So, I think it needs to be predictive. See far ahead, and be able to figure out the next move. That's crucial. A smart brain, sharp eyes, and quick reflexes. Our cars have it all.
Quick reflexes.
Our cars have it all.
Our cars have it all.
I just feel like we're missing an adjective or two. Bold, yet precise. I think first, we need to give every single passenger a huge sense of security. I think that's the most important thing. If a driver like my mom can feel confident and drive it safely, I think that's incredibly important. And the second thing, in my opinion, is there's still a ton of work to do. So, like I was saying, it can handle any residential area, any business park, basically all public and private roads. Hello? We've got our Xpeng friends over here. So, one of our top guys even suggested a feature. We should be able to recognize other Xpeng friends on the road and say hi. Look, as it's turning now, it cuts to the center line and moves right. And then I'm thinking, I wanna speed up, I'm gonna pass him, and boom, it instantly gets it. It understands your intent. That feeling is just awesome. I am super, super confident. I think our capabilities are probably 5 to 10 times that of our competitors. Like at that red light back there, there was a guy who tried to run it, but then he stopped halfway through. So the car made a really subtle move to avoid him. It didn't slam on the brakes, just safely maneuvered around, and then smoothly kept going. That's the kind of performance you'll see from our world model when it's officially released. So definitely stay tuned. Our cameras can already see incredibly far. Our Eagle Eye vision system actually sees farther and clearer than a human, even in harsh glare or in the middle of the night. Its overall visual feedback is better than ours. So, to really nail all these capabilities, you absolutely need an extremely powerful world model. Perfect following distance.
Because a large model perfect following distance.
The most important thing ultimately is that you get emergent behavior. We have a massive amount of data from. But for a big data model,
This huge world model can process all of this long-tail data and make sense of it all. And that's when you'll see it start doing things you never thought possible. Because it's all based on real human driving data, is what it can do. But I had to nudge the wheel to tell it to go. Otherwise, it wouldn't have dared to drive against traffic on this street. Our human AI co-pilot system covers both steering left and right, and also letting you lightly tap the accelerator. These two things, speed and steering, are both available at the same time. So how do you disengage the co-pilot? Basically, just hit the brakes. The second you touch the brake, it's over. Look at this car. This is pretty interesting. You all just saw the car up ahead try to go the wrong way, but it couldn't because of traffic. So it started backing up. So our NGP steered right to go around, waited for the car to back into its spot. And we just held our position and waited for it. Actually, in the future, we could even have it back up a little in response. We'll have some reversing capabilities soon, cause it's blocking people, so it's backing up. Our NGP should back up too. Right, on that note, I want to ask our Xpeng community. What other rare but really important edge cases, what other capabilities do we still need? Feel free to hit up our colleague, Yuan Tingting, on our Weibo or Douyin. You know the saying, a path is made by walking it. And I say, a road is also made by driving on it. Can we make it handle those places even better? That's what I think we need to achieve by 2026. For example, when we go out to the wilds of Qinghai, Xinjiang, Inner Mongolia, Tibet, the grasslands, the Gobi Desert, how do we drive there? And drive both fast and well. All right, Mr. He. What score would you give the assisted driving on the Xpeng MONA M03 Max today? I think today we were pretty much only on backroads. I mean, for a human. On a muddy, two-lane road with tons of construction, potholes, and all kinds of people. Tricycles, garbage trucks, construction vehicles all over the place. I think it did an incredible job today. I give it a perfect 100. For a car in this price range, I think it's a generational leap ahead. There is absolutely no competition. We'll keep iterating in future versions to make it even better. Alright, I hope you all leave me tons of comments on my Weibo. Any feedback, good or bad, product suggestions, leave me a comment. We are absolutely going to polish this assisted driving until it is flawless.